Cyber Monday spending is expected to top $11 billion today. The deepest discounts are expected to be on TVs, laptops, and beauty products.
Cyber Monday's roots are in tech. So anything that is tech-related that you did not get on Black Friday but that you want, so Cyber Monday's the time to get it.
As for larger purchases, this Thursday, December 1st, is when appliances are expected to be at their lowest price, averaging 18% off at most retailers. A huge factor looming over the holiday season is inflation at a 40-year high. The Federal Reserve has raised interest rates 6 times this year to cool the economy and bring down spending, putting pressure on retailers to sell as much as they can now.
They know that their budget's getting eaten up by their heating bill, their rent, these necessity grocery purchases. So the pressure is on, you know, for them to compete with each other and offer the richest deal possible.
On Black Friday, Americans spent more than $9 billion shopping online, a 2% increase from last year and higher than forecasted. But retailers are still losing ground when factoring in 7% inflation. And to cope with higher prices, many shoppers are turning to flexible payment plans. According to one estimate, buy now, pay later payments increased by 78% on Black Friday compared to the previous week.
Some economists say that the strong labor market is supporting this holiday spending, but it is unclear what happens if hiring slows in the new year.
As for what not to buy on Cyber Monday, wait on mattresses and furniture. Experts say better deals on those items can be had on President's Day. Andrea Fujii, ABC News, New York.